Om Mani Padme Hum. My name is Vajrashura, and I work here in the Dublin Buddhist Centre. I'm the manager and one of the teachers here in the Dublin Buddhist Centre. I was a bit resistant to Buddhism, I have to say, because I was, you know, I was a bit resistant to all organised religions after being a Catholic for most of my life, until just a few years before that. But a couple of years later, I discovered that, yeah, actually, I was a Buddhist, you know, in that, you know, I had to have some meaning in my life, and Buddhism just made more sense to me. So Buddhism, in my mind, isn't really a religion as such, because there's no God in it. And it doesn't ask you to suspend your disbelief. So for me, it was offering a path of development, a path of growth, a path to meaning, actually. So. Well, I guess it started with back in 1999 when I learned to meditate. So a friend of mine was very into meditation and yoga, and he kind of convinced me to do it. He convinced me to do yoga first, actually. I don't know if I would have done meditation initially, and I really enjoyed yoga. This was in college at the time. I was doing my master's. And I had a scientific training back then, so I was quite skeptical about this kind of stuff. But he convinced me, and I really enjoyed it. And then I did the meditation with someone from the Dublin Buddhist Centre down in the Trinity College Meditation Society. And I really loved it. It was really, really good. And you know, I loved how it made me feel. I loved the kind of spaciousness it gave me. I loved how it made me appreciate things again. You know, I think I've been in Trinity for about 5 years at that point, and I remember walking through it after learning to meditate, seeing it as if for the first time again. And well, on one level, my life looks the same from the outside. You know, I live in a rented accommodation with a few friends up in Phibsborough. I have a girlfriend. I drive a car. I go to work. You know, all those kind of things that people usually do. You know, you get stressed about Christmas presents. You know, all that kind of stuff. And at the same time, I work in the Buddhist Centre, so I work here with other Buddhists in a very kind of meaningful context. So the Buddhist Centre here isn't about making profit. It's about helping people learn to meditate, helping people become better human beings, you could say, helping them learn about Buddhism and so on. So in a way, I guess my life now has a lot more meaning in terms of what I do. What I do in my life is imbued with meaning. There are other things. I mean, as a Buddhist, you try and live on the basis of awareness and kindness as much as possible, or wisdom and compassion, you know. So that's a lot more conscious in my everyday life now than I would have been back then. And I guess there's other things, like I don't really drink much anymore. I don't do drugs, which I used to do back in the day. So I guess that's not out of an ideological position, but it's more that I find my life is more enjoyable and more simple. And it's more compatible with meditation, just to live simply and not to cloud the mind, and to take pleasure and joy from more simple things, and look for connections with people. You know, in a way, Buddhism has always been part of the mindfulness movement, but there is certainly a boom of late. And I think there's good and bad in it. I think the good in it is that the more people who learn about mindfulness, the better in many ways. You know, so I think people could use mindfulness. I think people need a bit more space in their lives to be able to deal with things. And on the other hand, I feel I have some concerns, because I don't think you can completely take out the spiritual out of mindfulness either. You know, if mindfulness is just a technique to turn you into a better consumer unit, or to make you more happy with your little work cubicle, then I'd really have to question the value of that. You know, I think there has to be a spiritual dimension to mindfulness. And the spiritual dimension for me is becoming a happier, healthier human being who can make the world a better place, you know?